Welcome to the tutorial on realization of adder and subtractor using decoder IC74139. Here we present you the IC74LS139, which is a 2:4 duo decoder IC or dual decoder IC. The 74LS139 comprises of two separate 2-line to 4-line decoders in a single package. The active low enable input can be used as a data line in demultiplexing applications. So if you observe the IC diagram that is shown here, the IC74LS139 has 16 pins, with the first pin represented as 1G corresponding to the enable pin, and you have 1A and 1B corresponding to two inputs of the decoder, and Y0 to Y3 correspond to the four output lines of the decoder. Similarly, you have 2G corresponding to the second enable pin, 2A and 2B corresponding to the inputs of the second decoder, and Y0 to Y3 corresponding to the output lines of the second decoder. So this particular IC is a combination of two 2:4 decoder, and you can observe the truth table corresponding to the IC74LS139, which shows that when the enable pin is high, irrespective of the type of the input that you give, the output is going to be all high. And when the enable pin is zero, depending upon the type of the input that you provide, the output will be active low. So the same thing has been explained here more in detail with respect to the logic symbol, wherein we have decoder A, which is exactly the left hand side, and the decoder B exactly towards the right hand side of the IC74LS139. So pin number 16, which is the VCC and ground, pin number 8 is the common thing corresponding to the two decoders. One more observation that we need to make here is that the enable pin is active low and the outputs are also active low. So when we want to use this particular IC for the realization purpose, we will try to implement the output in terms of active low. So we will be using the NAND gate when we represent in terms of minterms. So to explain this particular IC in more detail, we have the IC wherein clearly I have segregated in order to show you that it comprises of two 2:4 decoders. So this is one part and this is the other part. Moving on to the features, the 74LS139 IC is designed specifically for high speed, that means memory decoders, data transmission systems are used in this particular range. The 74LS139 contains two fully independent 2:4 line decoders or the demultiplexers, which I explained just now. We make use of these Schottky clamped diodes for high performance, and the typical propagation delay is 21 nanoseconds with the power dissipation of 34 milliwatts. So these are certain specifications that are specified in terms of the supply voltage, input voltage, the operating temperature range, and the storage temperature range. So coming to the experiment that we need to conduct, that is, we need to use this particular IC to realize the half adder, full adder, half subtractor, and full subtractor. So the first one, we have the half adder using the IC74139. So I have placed the truth table here, and you can see the outputs in terms of sum and the carry. So what I'm going to do here is I will represent the decimal notation corresponding to the input combinations. So you can see that 0, 1, 2, 3. And I'm writing the expression for the min terms corresponding to the sum and carry, and I get it as sum to be equal to summation m 1 comma 2 and carry is summation m 3. So here for this implementation of the half adder, I just require 2:4 decoder. Since 74139 IC consists of two 2:4 decoders, I'm just using the left hand side of the particular IC, and I am numbering the output lines so that I can clearly use the NAND gate IC. So I have the outputs 0, 1, 2, 3, which correspond to pin number 4, 5, 6 and 7 of the IC. And because the sum corresponds to minterm 1 and 2, I am going to use 5 and 6 pin and realize it using the NAND gate. So that gives me the sum. And for the carry, what I'm going to do is I'm going to use the NAND gate by shorting the inputs, and that will give me the carry. So to understand this realization in more detail, let me explain you with a small diagram. So here let me consider that I'm using a 74139 IC and a 7400 NAND IC. As you can clearly see that we just require two input NAND gates, so that is why I have used a 7400 IC. So what I have done is I have used pin number 5 and pin number 6, which correspond to 1 and 2 decimal notation, and that is being given to the NAND gate. The output of the first NAND gate is giving me the sum, and pin number 7 is given to the NAND gate where the two inputs are shorted. So 4 and 5 are shorted, and that is given to pin number 7. That is what is explained here. And the output of that particular NAND gate is pin number 6, which will be given to the carry. One major observation that you need to make here is that this is a 16 pin IC whereas this is a 14 pin IC. So in this particular case, pin number 8 is ground and pin number 16 is VCC, whereas here pin number 7 is ground and pin number 14 is VCC. So moving on to the implementation of the full adder using IC 74139. I'm going to repeat the similar procedure wherein I will mark the decimal notations, find out what is the expression in terms of shorthand decimal notations for the sum and the carry, and mark the parameter values corresponding to the decimal notations onto the IC 74139. So clearly I can see that in this particular case I require 4 input NAND gate. So the 4 input NAND gate realization can be done using the IC 7420, but in this particular case, since I need 2 NAND gates and I have 3 inputs, I need to make use of both the decoders present within the IC. That is why what we have done is we have used the input A, that is the MSB, to be 0 for the first decoder and to be equal to 1 for the second decoder. So let me explain this in more detail. So what I have done is I have represented the equivalent of this particular IC in terms of two separate 2:4 decoders, wherein A is given to be equal to 0 for the first decoder and A equal to 1 for the second decoder. The least significant bits B and C are considered as the inputs. So in the first case you will have A to be equal to 0 and BC will have four different combinations, that is 00, 01, 10 and 11. In a similar manner for the second 2:4 decoder, E is equal to 1 and you have four different combinations for B and C. Based upon the min terms that are represented, I am going to use the NAND gates and obtain the sum and the carry. Now, as I mentioned earlier, we are using the 7420 IC for the implementation of the full adder. So here I am presenting you the 7420 dual 4 input NAND gate IC, and you can clearly see that we make use of pin number 1, 2, 4 and 5 as the input and pin number 6 is the output. Similarly, we have pin number 13, 12, 10 and 9 as the input and pin number 8 is the output. Again, this is a 14 pin IC with the 7th pin grounded and 14 pin connected to VCC. And the truth table corresponding to the various input combinations has been shown. And you can see that for a combination of 1, 1, 1, 1, you get an output equal to 0. Now coming to the realization of the ARP subtractor using the IC74139. Like the way I have explained for the adders, for the subtractors as well, I am going to represent in terms of the decimal notations. I will obtain the expression in terms of shorthand decimal notation for the difference and the borrow, and you can clearly see that difference corresponds to summation M1,2 and borrow corresponds to summation 1. So I require 1 and 2 to obtain the difference, and I just require decimal notation 1 to implement the borrow. But when I compare and place these particular decimal notations for the IC74139, they correspond to pin number 5, 6. So I need to be careful because these correspond to the output lines. So comparing this, I can realize in a similar manner like the way I've explained earlier. I have the IC, just one particular decoder is sufficient. So I will keep the enable pin to be low and I'm going to use A and B, that is pin number 2 and 3 of the IC74139 as the inputs, and I'm going to use 1 and 2 which is given to the two inputs of the 7400. This is a 2 input NAND gate and the pin number 3 will give me the difference. To realize this particular borrow, you can see that we have shorted the NAND gate. So pin number 4 and 5 of the 7400 needs to be shorted and that needs to be given to pin number 7 of the 74139 IC, and output of the NAND gate will be obtained from pin number 6 which will give me the borrow. Again, you need to be careful with providing the ground and the supply. 16 is VCC for 74139, whereas 8 is ground, and here pin number 14 is VCC and pin number 17 is ground. Now coming to the full subtractor using the IC74139, this is again similar to that of the realization of the full adder. So decimal notations are used, difference is returned in terms of shorthand decimal notation, borrow is mentioned. The decimal notations are specified in the IC. Okay, so this is the first decoder, this is the second decoder. We have seen that earlier. And the first and the second decoder can be easily segregated. That also has been explained. So to further emphasize on what we have understood, a detailing has been done in this particular slide, wherein I have represented the main terms in terms of shorthand decimal notations. A, that is variable A, is considered as the MSB, which can be either 0 or 1. So 0 is considered for the first decoder and 1 is considered for the second decoder. And I'm going to use the NAND gate to realize this particular implementation of the full subtractor. An important thing to be recalled is that we are using the NAND gate specifically because this corresponds to the implementation for an active low output case. For the half adder using the 74139 IC, if you look at the truth table, we have four different combinations of the inputs: 00011011, and the output is 00101001. And in the logic diagram, we are going to use only the first half of the IC, that is 2:4 line decoder.
So we have the enable pin, which has to be kept at logic 0, and two inputs are provided, A and B, and the output is measured from sum and carry. So in the trainer kit, we have the IC which is placed, that is IC74139, which is a 16-pin IC, and we are making use of two input NAND gate, and this is a 14-pin IC. So here pin number 7 is ground and pin number 14 is VCC, whereas in the case of the 74139 IC, pin number 16 is VCC and pin number 8 is ground. So let me realize this particular circuit and check the output. So I will switch on the trainer kit, and here the first one is the enable pin. This is input A and this is input B. The enable is low and inputs are 00. So you can see the output obtained is also 00. Now enable has to be low for a combination of 01. I obtain the output to be 10. That is, sum is 1 and carry is 0. Whereas for a combination of 10, I obtain sum 1, carry 0. And for a combination of input 11, I obtain the sum to be equal to 0 and carry to be equal to 1. Now, moving on to the second realization, that is the full adder using IC74139. So here, if you look at the truth table, I have three inputs and I have the sum and the carry, which is the output. Since we have three inputs, we need to make use of both the decoders provided in the IC, and here we require a 4-input NAND gate. The explanation for the 4-input NAND gate using the IC7420 is already done earlier. So directly let us move into the realization for the circuit and compare the output of the truth table with that of the one obtained using the IC trainer kit. So here what I have done is, I have placed the IC74139 in the first zip socket. The second zip socket consists of the IC7420. And the third zip socket consists of the NOT gate. Why NOT gate is used is because, as we have seen, we make use of the variable A, which is the MSB, and that is connected to the enable pin, and the enable pin is given to be equal to 0 for the first decoder and it is connected to be equal to 1 for the second decoder. So we need to provide a NOT gate connection for the lower order, that is the second 2:4 line decoder. So let me realize this and check out the output. So we have, for the first case when the enable is 0 and the combination is 000. So with enable 0 and inputs A, B, C. When I say enable is 0, it means that MSB A is 0. So 000, I have the sum to be equal to 0 and carry is 0. Now, when I have 001, I have sum 1, carry 0, 10, sum 1, carry 0, 11, sum is 0 and carry is 1, 010, sum is 1 and carry is 0. In case I have 011 with sum 0, carry 1, And for the second case, when I consider A to be equal to 1 and B and C to be equal to 0, 0, sum is 1 and carry is 0. 1, 0, 1, sum 0, carry 1. 1, 1, 0, sum 0, carry 1. And 1, 1, 1, sum is 1 and carry is 1. So that completes the realization of full adder using IC74139. Now, moving on to the half subtractor, we had the truth table with two inputs and the outputs difference and borrow. So here we make use of the IC, and in this particular case we require just the NAND gate, and only one half of the decoder is required, so only the left hand side of the decoder is used for the implementation purpose. So let me quickly realize this using the trainer kit. So here I have the first IC74139 and I have the NAND gate IC. So the first one, first input is the enable input, which is considered to be at logic 0. Then you have the remaining inputs A and B, which are the inputs of the half subtractor. So 0, 0, you can observe that difference is 0, borrow is 0. 0, 1, difference is 1, borrow is 1. 1, 0, difference is 1 and borrow is 0. 1, 1, difference and borrow is 0, 0. Now, coming to the realization of full subtractor using IC74139. So in this case, we have three inputs A, B and C with outputs difference and borrow. In this case as well, like the way we have done for the implementation of the full adder, we will be using the variable A, which is the MSB, connected to the enable pin. So we are going to use it with enable equal to 0 and enable equal to 1. So both the 2:4 line decoders will be used for the implementation of the full subtractor. So let us compare the full subtractor truth table with the outputs. And we have made use of the IC74139 in the beginning, 7420, which is a 4 input NAND gate IC. And third, we have made use of the NOT gate because we need to provide the MSB in terms of A to be equal to 0 and A to be equal to 1. So let me switch on the trainer kit. So initially I have, this is the enable pin which has to be maintained at 0. This is A, B and C. So you can see for all inputs to be equal to 0, the output is 0, 0. For a case of 0, 0, 0, 1, I have difference and borrow to be equal to 1, 1. 0, 1, 0, difference and borrow is equal to 1, 1. 0, 1, 1, I have the difference to be equal to 0 and borrow is 1. And now what I need to do is, I need to make the enable pin high. So I am considering the second 2:4 line decoder. So 1, 0, 0, difference is 1 and borrow is 0. 1, 0, 1, both difference and borrow is 0. 1, 1, 0, I have both difference and borrow to be equal to 0. And 1, 1, 1, difference and borrow is equal to 1.